Stuff is official.
Marie Kondo made decluttering trendy.
It's exciting.
Turns out she has an academic soulmate in University of Virginia professor Lydie Klotz, who wrote the book Subtract, The Untapped Science of Less.
People systematically overlook subtraction as a way to make things better.
So less really can be more, we just stink at it. And Lydie has proof. In an experiment, he asked people to improve a ridiculously overstuffed travel itinerary to Washington, D.C.
It had 12 items on the itinerary, all happening in a single day.
It was designed so the most obvious improvement would be to remove items, but
people still overwhelmingly added to this itinerary.
People, we have a problem, so we're running down why we're addicted to addition and how to subtract instead. It starts with understanding why we're hardwired to add.
There are certainly evolutionary roots to this. Acquiring things helped make us more likely to survive and pass down our DNA from generation to generation.
Which means our brains have to work harder at subtraction.
To think of subtraction actually requires more cognitive effort.
What's more, the last year and a half has been particularly challenging, and stress makes subtraction even harder.
If we're overloaded in our thinking, you know, if you're worried about paying the mortgage and you're working two jobs, you've got a lot of stuff going on in your brain.
And instinct is easier on a tired out brain.
Because adding is our instinct, and the more we're relying on instinct, the more we'll go with adding.
So what can you do? Start by firing up the Post-it notes.
You've got to put in place reminders for yourself that subtracting is an option. How do we set these reminders up in all phases of our life? Because there's lots of things that we can improve by subtracting, from travel itineraries to our closets to the ideas that are in our brains.
Reminders can help fight instinct and the capitalist machine.
We don't need a useful reminder for, hey, if you add all this stuff to your house, it'll be better, because that's everything.
And your brain can't see what doesn't exist. So make subtraction visible. Let's say you cancel a meeting.
The next week, there's no evidence that you've subtracted to make your calendar better.
So train your future brain by leaving a mark.
Drop in a visible reminder of your subtraction, right? So it's like, this 2 hours brought to you by the repetitive meeting that you subtracted. We need to make the results visible to ourselves to show that, hey, you have indeed added value by subtracting.
Finally, in an addiction-addicted world, subtraction stands out.
Because people are overlooking subtraction, it leads to opportunities for people who don't.
Training your brain to consider subtraction as a way to improve schedules, systems, and designs can really pay off. For instance,
if you're familiar with the balance bike, these are these pedal-less bikes that have allowed two-year-olds to basically ride bikes way sooner than I could when I was growing up.
By keeping their feet available to avoid most falls, kids can focus on learning balance and steering.
The whole innovation there is taking away the pedals,
which subtracted a whole lot of scraped knees. Learning subtraction to add to our lives is at the top of the list.